Let's pray. God of goodness and love, we thank you for the blessings in our lives. Let us understand your purpose and plans for us. We pray for those who need you, those in the world who are suffering, those who are needing your presence. We pray for our town. Let us be good neighbours and friends. We pray for our church, that we will be able to meet together safely sometime soon, and that we remember to act the way Jesus taught us to and look out for each other. Help us at school to be people who shine with your goodness and light and reflect your love to others. In Jesus' name, Amen. On Palm Sunday, we will think of when Jesus entered Jerusalem. It marks the beginning of Holy Week in the Christian calendar, one where many important things happened. God's people had waited on their Saviour coming for a very long time and began to believe Jesus was indeed him, a Saviour who would release them from the rule of Romans. However, Jesus did not live up to those expectations. He turned all those things upside down. Jesus approached Jerusalem riding a donkey, a sign that he came in peace. The people had hoped that their Saviour was going to help free them from being ruled by the Romans, and the crowds turned out to welcome him, waving palm branches in celebration. The week began with people in Jerusalem excitedly welcoming Jesus, but it turned around and the people became disappointed because they had expected Jesus to lead them against the Romans. What they hadn't realised was that Jesus hadn't come to change the leadership, but to change people's hearts. He said this in John chapter 18, verse 36. My kingdom does not belong to this world. No, my kingdom does not belong here. The people were upset that what they thought was going to bring about their freedom was not going to. That Jesus was not planning to overthrow the Romans. God's plan wasn't anything like what they'd hoped it would be. The people's hearts grew cold, and they had turned against Jesus by the end of that same week. As this happened amongst the people of Jerusalem, one of Jesus' disciples, Judas Iscariot's heart, also hardened against Jesus, and he entered into a bargain with the chief priests to hand Jesus over to them. Our own expectations and opinions of what God should do are often not what God has in fact planned for us. We get upset if God doesn't do as we ask or expect, but he has a very different, much higher plan than ours often are, because he knows what's best for us. He knows our lives from beginning to end. On the surface, we as humans would want to rescue Jesus from that cross because we don't like thinking about Jesus suffering or dying, but Jesus had to die on it so that Easter Sunday morning could come. God's plans are sometimes hard for us to understand. What we need to do is follow and trust, instead of expecting God's plans to always match ours. When we celebrate Palm Sunday, we think of God's plans for Jesus. It was a plan that did not make sense to people then, and sometimes still makes little sense to people now. But God's plans are always perfect and always based upon his great love for us. The whole plan has not finished yet, because the Bible says Jesus will return one day. But what happened at Easter brought about the defeat of death. When Jesus emerged from the tomb on Easter Sunday morning, God won and the enemy was defeated. No matter what happens to us in life, whether we win some things or lose some things, or in good times or through difficult times, God is always there for us and his plan is always, always what's best for us. Even when, like the people in Jerusalem, we don't quite understand it at the time. Thank you, God, that you know the plans you have for us, and they are plans for good. Amen. Aim for the week. Let's remember this week that God has a plan for every one of his children. Let's try to trust him as much as Jesus did as he approached Good Friday. Let's remember that the darkness of Good Friday did pass and Easter Sunday did dawn. God's plan is perfect, even if we can't see it in full all at once.